Hi guys and welcome back to my channel. So today all I have on is my foundation, concealer, and eyebrows. And that is because we are going to be testing out some new products. I went to Ulta yesterday with my mom and got a few things. I'm testing out two things and the other thing I got I'm not testing out. But I got the Stila Magnificent Metals Glitter and Glow in Rose Gold Retro. I've really been wanting this one. This is not what we're doing the review on. You know that I love these already. I have the Molten Midnight one. And I've been wanting one of the like gold pinky sparkly ones. And it was between this one and something satin, which they've sold out of that one. Hi, that rhymed. But anyway, I've been wanting either this one or the satin one. And that is what that looks like. And it is gorgeous. But like I said, we're not using that today. I was just showing you because that's the other thing I got from Ulta. Okay, so I'm testing out a couple of things from the new Tarte Make Believe in Yourself collection. I got the face or eyes and cheek palette and the Pro Glow like liquid highlighter in Stunner. They did have another highlight, like powder highlight. And then they had two liquid lipsticks, and I really do like the liquid lipsticks. There was this really pretty, like, mauvey pink, and then there was, like, a green, teal, blue, almost like the color of my beauty sponge, only a little bit more blue-toned. And they were both really pretty, but nothing that I felt like I needed. I'm just gonna put this down here. And then they had the highlighter that like looks like the rainbow, but in this palette actually comes with the highlighter as well, and I actually kind of liked it better. And I wasn't going to buy the other highlight just because it was rainbow, because to be honest it really wasn't anything that special. But anyway, we're going to be reviewing the palette, which is gorgeous. I love the packaging. We'll get to the colors and stuff in this later, but first we're going to be testing out the Pro Glow, and I'm loving the, this is basically the color that the lipstick was. And then the other one was kind of like a mauvey pink, like some of the packaging. I love the theme of this makeup. It's very like summer and spring and reminds me of like magic and unicorns. And I think it's supposed to be like festival, but it's so pretty. Anyway, so this is what the highlighter looks like. And I'm going to apply that to my face before I put on any powder because it is a liquid. And yeah, that's why we're doing that first. I'm going to do a little swatch of it first for you. Okay, so here's that Stila Rose Gold on my hand. But I'm just going to do a little swatch of this. That's what it looks like. It is gorgeous, very intense, but a very pretty, pretty color. And I think that it will go really good on a lot of skin tones, because it's not too like icy, but it's not too warm either. It's just a very pretty like pinky champagne. And I'm actually going to swatch the highlighter that comes in the palette as well. And my plan is to actually put that highlighter on top of this. I'll show you the powder highlight on its own. It's not as intense, obviously, because it's a powder, but when I layer them together, I can get myself in focus. When you layer them together, it is gorgeous. So that is my plan. So I'm just going to apply this with my finger because I don't want my sponge to soak up any product. And let me zoom you in for this as well. I always forget to turn it off before I start filming, and if I don't, then you would hear that the entire time. Okay, so this is gorgeous and blends out so well. And if you didn't want it quite this intense, you could always use a sponge and it would be a little bit more sheer. But I like the intense, so that's why we're doing it this way. Okay, so now I'm going to take the powder highlight in the palette, and I'm going to pick some of that up, obviously, and I'm going to layer that on top of this while it's still kind of tacky, so it'll really pop. And it feels weird to do highlight first before anything else, but I really want to be able to layer these to where they're going to look very strobey. That is so pretty. Oh my gosh. I love the color. And I'm very, very pale. So if it works on me, it'll work on anyone. Now if you get very dark skin tones, like if you're extremely tan, it may be a little bit too light for your liking, but it's not going to be too dark on anyone. But I don't think it's like frosty, like white either. Now the highlight in the palette is more of like a white shade, but even still it has like a golden undertone, not a silver. So I think it's very, very flattering. Okay, so I'm going to finish up the rest of my face and then we'll move on to the eyes. Okay, so I have the rest of my face makeup on and I am absolutely loving this highlight. Like, it is gorgeous. It's so intense, but in like such a pretty way. It's like not obnoxious, which I like obnoxious. It doesn't bother me. But I just think it's so pretty. Now, these items are a limited edition. This highlighter is $20 and you get 0.56 ounces. Let me get the bottle out again. But it's a pretty good size bottle and you just have to use the itty bittiest amount. But I would recommend using your finger so that your sponge is not soaking up the product, because you will go through it a lot quicker and not get the intensity. You'll have to use a lot more to get this intense. And you can layer any powder highlight on top of it. If you want a very similar look, Becca's Pearl is a lot like the one that's in here. It's a little bit more icy. But you can layer any highlight you like on top of this and it's going to make it look gorgeous. Or it's very pretty on its own if you just do like a, I can't do just cream products and not set them. But if you can, then it's gorgeous. But yeah, I think it's worth the $20, even though it is limited edition. You're not going to use it up that quick. I mean, unless you're using it every single day, which you're probably not going to. But just for days when you're feeling extra sassy, I think it's worth it. I think it's gorgeous. I love the color. Blends great. I don't know how it's going to wear, but it'll probably wear pretty good, I'm guessing. I'll do a check-in later, just to see. But for 20 bucks, I think this is awesome. Do you need it in your life? Probably not. But if you're a makeup addict like me and you like the glow, then I think this is a good product. Okay, so moving on to the palette, which I'm so excited about. It is gorgeous. The back is gold. The front looks like unicorn. And it's just so pretty. And this is the Make Believe in Yourself, which I think is so cute. That's the name of it. And this is what it looks like. It is gorgeous for spring and summer. And then you get a good size mirror in here as well. But I think the packaging is just gorgeous. I love Tarte packaging anyway, a lot of the times. Basically, you get the highlighter, which does not have a name, which aggravates me. So, it's just the highlighter. Whatever. And then you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. You have 10 shades in total. 9 are like metallic, foiled looking shadows. And then you have one neutral matte shade. So I'm guessing the idea behind this palette is for like spring and summer, just to put a little bit of this matte shade in your crease and then pop any one of these like metallic shimmers on your lid, which I think is a great idea. I know a lot of people like to have a lot of mattes, and I even talked about that in the Tarte Bunny palette, how I wish that had just a darker matte shade, like for a more intense look, but I still like the palette. Same with this one, and I think for the idea that they're going with, that one matte shade is plenty, and I love the color that they went with. It's perfect and it'll go great with each and every one of these shades. Now, if you want to bring in other matte shades, obviously you could make a more intense look, or you could just do the glowy, summery, easy look with these. I am going to do some swatches before I apply them to my eye because I don't know which shade I want to use yet. But let me go get some wipes because I'm going to need to wipe my fingers off. But yeah. We'll do some swatches real quick and then we'll get into applying them. So I'm going to start swatching the matte shade and then go clockwise so that way y'all can follow along, and I will state the names as well. So the matte shade is called Myth, and it's a very neutral toned nude, kind of like a beige. If I had to pick between if it was warm or cool, I would probably say, you know what, I don't even know. It's got some very pinky tones in there, and also looks like maybe it has some peachy tones as well. So it's very, very neutral. So I guess it would just depend on your skin tone if it pulled more cool or warm. But I think that it is a gorgeous matte shade and perfect for just a transition. Okay, so the next shade is Magic. And it is gorgeous. It's kind of like a bronzy brown shade. Very, very pretty and neutral. And if you're just going for a very easy, simple look, this in the crease and that on the lid is perfect. Which really is the case with all of these. But this is like one of the more neutral shades. But still very, very pretty. Next we have Wings, which is probably going to be one of my favorites. And this is like a very coppery bronze. And you can tell the difference. This one is looking a lot more brown with this next to it. But this is a lot like Flamethrower from Makeup Geek, which is one of my favorites. I've talked about that before. But it's just a very pretty coppery bronze. Very warm, very intense. And I like it. Okay, next we have Marvel, which is a gorgeous like green shade, and it's kind of got like some gold, it looks like, in there. A very gold based green, and it is so, so pretty and bright, and I really like that one as well. I've not swatched all these, just like one or two, and that was in store. I actually haven't touched this palette other than the highlighter since I've had it, so I'm excited to get a good look at these, and so far I'm loving everything. Okay, next is one that I swatched in store, and I think it's going to be my favorite in the palette, and it is called Trace. No, not Trace, Trance. And it is absolutely gorgeous. It's a very unique shade. I forgot to swatch it on camera. But it's like a silvery bronze, if that makes sense. Like, it's still got a bronzy tone in it, but it's very... got like a very cool toned silvery base, and it's almost got like a purple scent, like traces of purple in it. I don't know, it's just a very unique shade, and I just think it's so, so pretty, and probably the one that I'm going to put on today. We'll see. Okay, so now we have some more bright shades, which I've not swatched at all. The first one is Fairy, and it's just a very pretty purple. Like a kind of a dark purple, and you can see that this has some purple in it next to this, but it's not like purple, but that is very, very pretty. I want to actually go good with my hair. It's kind of a blue toned purple, not very pink at all, very blue gray toned, very pretty. Okay, next we have one that I think is also going to be a favorite, and this is called Mystic, and this is a very icy blue. Oh my gosh, it's gorgeous. And these swatch amazingly. I hope they apply well to my eye. Like I said, I haven't tried it yet, so we'll see. But this is absolutely gorgeous, like for the summer especially. That is so pretty and so metallic. You can see the light catching it. Okay, next we have another blue, but it's more of a darker blue. It's not dark, but it's darker. And it's kind of got like a green tone to it, kind of like a turquoise sort of. Ooh, it's very pretty as well. I like this one better, but this one's still very, very pretty. Okay, so now we have Crystal, which looks like a light golden champagne shade. yeah, they don't hardly show up on my skin. It's kind of like my skin tone, only shiny. It's actually very, very pretty and would actually make a really good highlight on some skin tones. Probably be a little bit too dark for me, but still very, very pretty. It's actually a very similar shade to the liquid highlight. Maybe just a tad bit darker. Very pretty though. Okay, next we have a golden pink, and this is called Pixie. And it's like a golden peachy pink. Very, very pretty. Any of these would be great if you're wanting more of a neutral look. That is so, so pretty though. I love that. I hope it's showing up on camera as well as it is in person. It's just very peachy with like gold undertones. Very pretty. Okay, and that was the last one. I'll swatch the highlighter one more time as well. The highlighter is like white, and then if you look, it has like some, looks like gold and pink shimmer in it. And I don't know how well you'll be able to see it. Yeah, you can. It is so, so pretty. So there's everything. Everything's swatched gorgeous. I don't know. I think I'm going to go with Trance and then maybe put some Pixie in the corner, inner corner, and then obviously put Myth in the crease. Okay, so let me wipe these off and we'll get started on my eyes. Okay, so I have concealed my eyes and powdered them down. I always recommend having some kind of base on your eye before you go in with eyeshadow. It's just going to make everything look better and more opaque and cleaner, and it cancels out any redness or veins that you have on your eyes. So I do have them concealed and powdered, but I'm just going to go in. Let me get me a clean, fluffy brush. I need to clean my brushes. Okay, so I'm just going in with a tapered blending brush, and I'm going into Myth, which is the matte shade right here, and just dipping in. These shadows are very, very soft, I can tell already, but I'm just going to add that to the crease and like transition area. So basically this entire area over the lid except for the brow bone. That is so, so pretty, and it's already applying very opaque, but it's blending really well. I love that. That's so pretty. It's a very universal shade, too. Now, my only complaint is because you are going to use this matte shade so much, you're going to go through it. So, I wish they could have somehow made, like, the matte shade a little bit bigger, but you can always just bring in a different matte shade and use any of these shadows, so it's not really that big of a deal. But if you use this every time you use the palette, which I probably will, you're going to go through it pretty fairly quickly. But that is such a pretty, pretty shade. I love it. Okay, so that's what the crease looks like. I'm very happy with the way that blended and the amount of color that I got. Now I'm going into Trance, and I'm just using my finger. I always do this with shimmery shades on the lid, and I'm just dipping into that, and I'm just going to apply this to the entire lid. And you can always use a brush, and you could probably even wet your brush and make it even more intense. I might even try that. I don't know. We'll see. It's so intense though and pretty. Oh my gosh, that is gorgeous. I knew I was going to like this shade. That is so, so pretty. I like that a lot. Okay, so just to see if I can make it any more intense, which it's already like super, super intense, we're just going to play. I'm just going to grab some like setting spray, and I'm just going to grab a flat shader brush and dip into that shade. And now I'm not going to put a wet brush in this because I don't think you can use these wet. I'm not sure, but I'm not going to do that because I don't want to ruin it. So I'm just putting it on the brush and then spritzing the brush. I don't want to cause my palette to have any hard spots, but we're just going to Actually, it went on a lot more intense just with my finger. So that's how I would recommend using it, which is what I'm just going to continue to do. I don't know if you can tell, but this was with a brush and then this was with my finger. So I'm just going to go in with my finger again. So now I'm just going to take my blending brush and just barely go in the crease again. I didn't add any extra product, just making sure it's blended. Okay, now I'm going to take the shade, oh, my baby's waking up, he's been asleep the whole time. Let me go get him. He's not used to waking up by himself and he was scared. Look at that hair, goodness. That's bedhead, bubby. What do you got in your hair? He's just now waking up, him bashful. Did you sleep good? Yeah. Look at the camera. Look up here. Look. Look, camera. You want a brush? There you go. No, let's not put the brush in Mommy's new palette. You're so sweet. What's that on your head? Okay, you want this brush? Brush your hair. No, don't put it in that. Brush your hair. It needs brushed. Oh, good job. It looks like a hairbrush, doesn't it? You're so sweet. Can Mommy have Shuggy? Morning, Shuggy. My sweet boy. Okay, so now I'm going to take the shade Crystal, which is the kind of a, like champagne silvery color. It's kind of like the same color that's on my lid, only lighter. So I'm going to take that and just tap it. Oh, let's not put that in my palette, bubby. Keeps wanting to stick my big makeup brush in my palette. But I'm just going to pat that to the very center just to brighten it up just a little right there. It looks very pretty. I'm loving this palette. And just going to do the same on the other side. Okay, now I'm just going to take a little Precise eyeshadow brush, if I can find the one I'm wanting. Oh, right here. And I'm actually going to go into the highlight and I'm going to tap that to the inner corner. And there we have it. Okay, so I'm gonna hop off here and finish my eyeliner and put on some mascara and stuff. And then I will hop back and give you my final thoughts on everything. Okay, so my final thoughts are that I love both of these products. The highlight is gorgeous. The makeup, the eyeshadow is gorgeous. I love it. Love the packaging. It's $40 for the eyeshadow palette, but you do get 10 shades and a highlight. The eyeshadows are gorgeous. Now, if you're someone that doesn't like foiled metallic eyeshadows, don't get it. But if you do, I totally think it's worth it. Like I said, with the highlighter, do you need it? Probably not. But if you just love makeup and you love using makeup, then I say go for it. I can't get... I'm wearing these fake nails. Oh, there we go. But it's just so pretty. And like I said, you could just use, like I did today, and just use like the matte shade with some of this on the lid. And then be fine, not even put eyeliner on, put on some mascara and go. Or you can make it more intense and bring in other shadows, which isn't a problem for me. Like when I sit down and do makeup, I'll grab 5 or 6 shadow palettes and just lay them in front of me and pick and choose from each one. Like I enjoy doing that. If you're somebody that wants to be able to do an intense smoky eye with one palette and you do that all the time, that's kind of how my mom is. Like she's more like mattes. Likes matte shades and likes to have everything in one palette that she needs. So this is probably, she would never buy this. This isn't something, she thinks it's pretty and she loved it when I bought it and even mentioned it today. She just came downstairs and she's watching the baby. But it's not something she would buy for herself. So just know what you like, and if you like these kind of things, then I think that it's great. I think that the pigment is great. It blends beautifully. The matte shade is just perfect. I have nothing to complain about. I've only had it on a few minutes. I don't know how they're going to wear. I may do a check-in later. I may not. We'll see. We'll see. I will. I'll do a check-in later. I'm actually going bike riding and stuff tonight. So I'll just check in tonight before I wash my face, tell you how long the makeup's been on. It is just now 12:17. I've had it on for a while, so we'll say noon. Till whenever, so we'll see how long this looks good. And I'm happy with it. I think it's perfect for summer, and I love it. So, like I said, you just decide if you like these kind of shades and formulas of eyeshadow, but the color and the way they apply it and stuff is 10 out of 10. I think it's worth $40. I think the highlighter is worth $20, and I'm very, very satisfied, and I love it. So that is my review and my opinion, and take it as you will. Like I said, if you know you better than anyone else, so you'll know if you like this. Go to Ulta, swatch it for yourself. They have the samples out for that. That's what I always do. I never buy anything unless I swatch it first. That's just how I am. I like to be able to see it in person and play with it. That's why when I leave Ulta, I have swatches all the way up my arm. I'm always a mess. Always. It never, ever fails. I actually just posted an Instagram picture yesterday of the swatches on my hand, and I didn't even get the back of it. I had them down this way, too. But that's just how I am, and I highly suggest swatching things before you buy them, because you can pretty much get an idea if it's going to be something that you're going to wear. But yeah, so like I said, 2 thumbs up. I love it, and I love you guys. Please like, comment, and subscribe. Actually, I'm not leaving yet because I'm going to do a check-in, so just stay tuned for that. I was ready to go, but I'm not ready to go because we're doing check-ins. Okay, so I will check in later. Okay, so this is check-in number one. Everything is still going great. I'm in natural lighting now. The highlighter is still very intense. The eyeshadow is still like it was when I put it on. So I've had it on for probably, what time is it? Hey, Mom.
Yeah.
Hold on, never mind, I got my phone. It's 5 o'clock, so everything's been on for 5 hours and still doing good. So I'll check in again later. Okay guys, so last check-in, I'm in horrible lighting. I'm sitting in my living room in front of my lamp. You can see my mirror behind me has little kitty prints all over it from this little fella over here, because he likes to talk to himself in the mirror and get food and spit and all the good things on here. It is 10 o'clock, so this makeup has been on for 10 plus hours. The eyeshadow is still very much intact. You can't tell as much in this lighting, but it's still, let me look at myself. Yeah, it's still completely there, and I'm very, very happy with it. The highlight is actually, you probably can't see, maybe a little bit right there, but it is still very strong and still beaming, basically. Now, my contour and blush and stuff, it has basically faded, so actually the highlight held up a lot longer than the rest of my face makeup. Like, looking at it, like, it's not as intense as it was, obviously, when I first applied it, but it's still definitely very much there, and for 10 hours, I think that this is good. I'm very, very impressed with the eyeshadow, and the amount of time that has stayed on my lids. And I have been bike riding and everything. Been playing with the baby, you know, went out to eat, all those things. So definitely, you know, I've been sweating, things like that. So it's definitely held up. I'm very, very impressed that this is still on there. My baby's been so sweet. But yeah, that's pretty much it. So I definitely give this 2 thumbs up. Love it. Think it's worth the money. If you like these kind of products, go out and get them before they are gone, because it is limited edition. And that is everything. So highly recommend. And that's basically it. But I love you guys, and I will talk to you soon. Bye. He wanted to say bye too. Give him sugar. Low sugar. Oh, that's good.